seek to have innovative solutions, that they're going to have a fair playing field. And I think this addresses that. My first question is for Ms. Slaiman, and I want to know how you would apply traditional antitrust law, what exists today, the goal of which is to protect consumers from high prices, to the subject of today's hearing, which is the power of gatekeepers online. Ms. Slaiman, do you think that there's room in existing law for courts to use existing antitrust law to protect consumers, or do we need changes to the law?
Thank you so much, Congressman. We absolutely do need changes to the law. I have very much appreciated the antitrust cases that have been brought already by the Department of Justice, the Federal Trade Commission, and state enforcers against Google and Facebook. And I think that those cases are doing a great job in the direction of trying to address this problem. But really, the problem is much broader than any particular antitrust violations that may have occurred. So even if those cases are very successful and we get really strong remedies out of them, I think we would still be left with this fundamental gatekeeper problem and the structure of the market that tends towards monopoly. So that's why it's so important to add on top these regulatory tools like interoperability and non-discrimination.
And even if current antitrust laws could address the monopolistic conduct of gatekeepers, and it sounds like your opinion is that it cannot, are they sufficiently fast enough and clear enough to deter that conduct in any meaningful way?
The length of time that it takes to do antitrust enforcement is also, I think, a real limitation. And that's something that other witnesses have talked about as well. We can work on trying to speed that up. But I do think that having ex ante rules set in advance can save so much time and provide more certainty for businesses as they are deciding how to operate in the market, for them to know interoperability is going to be required or discrimination is not going to be allowed. That can really save a lot of litigation time and help those businesses.
Ms. Slaiman, I listened to your opening statement where you argue that we need new sector-specific laws. Since the beginning of antitrust policy, though, we've had broadly applicable laws which apply to every industry equally. So why does technology require its own laws? And if we do it that way, wouldn't every industry come up with its own complaints and want its own laws?
Well, many industries are already subject to pro-competition regulation. A lot of these ideas are inspired by the communications industry, where we have pro-competition regulation. I'm also thinking of the Cable Act, where we have pro-competition regulation. So although this is new, we want to learn the lessons from those other industries, but many industries are regulated for competition, and I think that is fully justified to do that here.
Great. Thank you, and I yield back.
The gentleman moves back. I now recognize the gentleman from Florida.